This video is going to be about solving rational equations. So let's look at an example and see what we're talking about. Okay, here I've got an equation with a bunch of x's in it. And you notice there are variables in the denominators. That makes these rational equations. So what I'm starting out with is x over x plus 3 plus 1 over x plus 1. And that equals 3x plus 5 over x squared plus 4x plus 3. Now, the first thing you have to do when you're dealing with equations like this is find out what the excluded values are. Excluded values are values for x that you can't have. And you wouldn't be able to have them because, remember, you can't have a fraction with a denominator of 0. So if we look, for instance, at the first fraction, x over x plus 3, we realize that if x equaled negative 3, the denominator would be 0. So I cannot have, x cannot equal negative 3. If I look at the second fraction, I have x plus 1. And if I think of x plus 1 equals 0, then it would mean that x would be negative 1. And that means negative 1 is also an excluded value. So x cannot equal negative 1. So now I've got my excluded values. There's also the fraction on the right, which has a denominator of x squared plus 4x plus 3. Let's see what the excluded values for that are. Now, in order to do that, we have to factor it. So I'm going to factor x squared plus 4x plus 3. Since I've got an x squared as my first term, each of my binomials will have an x squared. And then the signs are positive, so it means I'm going to have x plus something and x plus something. And since the last number is a 3, that must be a 1 and a 3. And I can mentally multiply this back, and I'm going to see that I get x squared plus 4x plus 3. So I've got x plus 1 times x plus 3. Now, since those two factors, those two binomials, are the same as what I already have in the left side of the equation, I've got no new excluded values. So my excluded values are negative 3 and negative 1. Okay, now, the next step in dealing with fractions is to find the lowest common denominator. So the lowest common denominator is a number, or an algebraic expression in this case, that we can turn each of the denominators into by a multiplication process. So I look at this x plus 3 on the left, and then on the right I've got x plus 1 times x plus 3 as a denominator, and I realize I could turn x plus 3 into that denominator on the right by multiplying it by x plus 1. So for those two fractions, the first one and the third one, my denominator, my lowest common denominator, is going to be x plus 1 times x plus 3. Looking at the next fraction, x plus 1, I could turn that into this denominator on the right by multiplying it by x plus 3. So I can turn everything into this denominator here on the right. So my lowest common denominator, my LCD, is going to be x plus 1 times x plus 3. Okay? Now, when you've got an equation with fractions and you know what the LCD is, you can get rid of those fractions by multiplying each part of the equation by the LCD. In other words, each of the fractions in the equation is going to be multiplied by the LCD. So that means I'm going to have x plus 1 times x plus 3, that's the LCD, times the fraction x over x plus 3. I'm going to add that to the second fraction, multiplied by the LCD, and the LCD is, once again, x plus 3. I guess x plus 1 is what I'm starting with. X plus 1 times x plus 3 times the fraction 1 over, what was that, x plus 1. And then I get to the right side of the equation. Once again, I need that LCD. That's x plus 1 times x plus 3 times the fraction I had there. That was 3x plus 5 over x plus 1 times x plus 3. Now we can simplify everything very quickly. Looking at the first fraction, I've got a denominator of x plus 3, and one of the things I'm multiplying it by is x plus 3. So I can cross those both out. Then I'll just simplify what's left. I've got x plus 1 times x, so that's going to be x squared plus x. I'm just multiplying those two together. In my second fraction, I've got an x plus 1 in the denominator, and it's being multiplied by x plus 1, so I can cancel those out. And then I've got just x plus 3 times 1. Well, that's just x plus 3. So the right side of my equation is x squared plus x plus x plus 3. Let's see what that equals. Well, I'm sorry, that's the left side. When I look at the right side of the equation, I'm going to have a denominator that's x plus 1 times x plus 3. And in the numerator, what's multiplying it is x plus 1 times x plus 3. So both of those expressions, both of those binomials, will cancel. And I'll just have 3x plus 5. Okay, so let's simplify this. I've got an x squared. I'm going to get all of my terms on the left side of the equation and set it equal to 0. Then I've got an x plus x, that's 2x on the left, and I've got 3x on the right. So if I subtract 3x from both sides, I'll end up with just x plus x, or 2x minus 3x, would just be negative x. And then I've got a 3 on the left and a 5 on the right. So I'll subtract 5 from both sides. 3 minus 5 is negative 2. There's nothing left on the right side of the equation, so that all equals 0. Now I've got x squared minus x minus 2 equals 0, and I'll factor that. So let's see. If I've got just an x squared, that means both of my binomials will begin with an x. I've got a negative 2 at the end of this. Well, the only way I can think of to make a 2 would be 2 times 1, but it's a negative 2. So one of these two numbers will be negative and one will be positive. And if I think about it, I want that to be a negative 2 and a positive 1. So I've got x minus 2 times x minus 1 equals 0. And then what I'm thinking is x minus 2 equals 0. So if x minus 2 equals 0, then x equals 2. I've also got an x plus 1 equals 0, and that would mean that x would equal negative 1. So now I've got two answers, x equals 2 and x equals negative 1. This is where I want to go back to my excluded values, the first thing I did. I found out that x could not equal negative 3 or negative 1. Well, I don't have a negative 3, but I do have a negative 1. So this is not a possible answer, x minus 1. That leaves me with x equals 2. And the safest thing you can do now is take that 2, go back to the original equation, put a 2 in everywhere where you have an x, and make sure it still balances. Okay? So that's basically the process. A lot of steps, so a lot of places where you have to be careful, but it's obviously something you can do. Okay, I'm going to do at least another one of these, but there's no more time in this video. So stick around. I'll see you soon.